the stage, Marcus Max.
What's happening, everybody? What's up? Put your hands together. I want y'all to clap for yourselves for coming out tonight. And the first thing I want to do is I want to apologize to y'all for taking 3.5 motherfucking months to throw the show. That was a lot. We would never do that again, okay? Now, one thing I want to ask y'all right now, are we ready for once a month? Y'all ready for once a month? Y'all gonna support me that? Can we go to a once a month format? Okay, all right, okay. Let's get this stage started. To my right, DJ Knock.
Let's go.
Step it up for him.
Yes, sir.
My boy. At the front door, First Lady of Goberry Productions. TK Stanfield. The man that's responsible for all our photos and video, Van the cameraman. Hi, and I am Marcus Mack. Now I just want to go over a few rules and regulations. Y'all know the rules now. No heckling. People pay some good money to come in this place. Now if you want to be a comedian, come to the open mic and you laugh your ass off and tell all the jokes you want to, but for right now, shut up. I got a security guard downstairs that will throw your ass out that window. Alright? So let's chill with it. Now, your cell phones. Put them on vibrate. You ain't got to cut them off. Put them on vibrate. But before you cut them off, put them on vibrate. Take a picture of me. So I'm gonna pose for you. Put that shit on Facebook. Tag that shit. Tag me back. Yeah, put it all on there. Now, the last rule, we want y'all to just have fun tonight, okay?
Yes.
Have a good time. Now, we're gonna bring up two guest acts. You know, unfortunately, you know, we wasn't able to put them up as feature acts tonight, but, you know, hey, we only got one checkbook and one stage and one mic. You know, everybody gonna get a chance, everybody gonna get a time. But anyways, this first brother comes to the stage. Been getting down for a long time. He a day one brother. Y'all all know him. His name is, put your hands together everybody for Big Tree. So y'all give it up for Big Tree. That's some funny ass shit right there. That was funny. I ain't gonna say shit about that night and shit on though. That would be my 18th wedding anniversary, y'all. 18 years. Y'all do know what that means, right? Yeah, that means I jack off a lot. Don't get it wrong, though. I got a beautiful marriage. I got a real beautiful marriage. It just shit changes in the bedroom after 18 years. You know what I'm saying? I could be upstairs feeling good about myself. I call downstairs to my wife and I say, baby, you come on up here and let me work that out for you. And I said, when we first got married, she used to say, all right, baby, it's hot and ready like a Little Caesar's pizza. I'm on my way. That's how she used to talk. Now I say that shit, she be yelling back at my ass, nigga, I'm cooking. Come up here and fold these motherfucking clothes and clear this kitchen. And maybe we can do a little something. That's what I'm saying. She put me in this nigga, just gave me an hour to work work. Shit. For a little something? If I could do hours worth of work, I should get an hour's worth of the woods. Shit, that's the way it is. Y'all look good in here tonight, though. I don't see no lace front eyebrows. Got lace front eyebrows. Y'all look real good up here. But we're gonna keep this thing going. The next time I'm coming to the stage, Doc Rue. This is my boy. Y'all put y'all hands together for Mr. Calvin.
Yeah.
now. Give my mother a piece of pussy. Such a dick. And I know somebody out there saying, I'm not this guy. I'm not one. That's right. Off the showroom floor, because I thought that's what it was going to take for this young lady to love me. You know, it was cool. The first 3 months was cool. Shit. $1,300 a month for this motherfucking Corvette. 3 months later, I was hiding that motherfucker in my sister's garage. The vet was on one side, I was sleeping on the other side. I said, shit. But that's what I thought. I thought, you know, it was going to take to have this young lady love me. Needless to say, I lost both the motherfuckers, too. I lost both of them. Some things ain't even material. Sometimes you can do dumb shit with a female, you know, that ain't got nothing to do with money. I was dating this one lady one time. She said, man, you know, if you shave all the hair off your dick, it'll make it look bigger. I said, oh, really? Is that right? Shit, get them clippers. Let's do this. It worked too. Apparently, it looked like it worked. Now, before y'all start getting all excited, let me explain something to you. See, when motherfuckers fail to tell you, when you shave all the hair off your dick, it never grow back the same. My shit was luxurious before I cut my shit off. My shit was soft and fluffy. My shit was like a rabbit tail. That shit grew back like Velcro. That shit was sticking my ass like Velcro too. You get one of rogue ass hairs poking you in your nuts, that shit will make a grown man stop doing whatever the fuck he's doing. He's dead in this motherfucking track. I was in a golf swing in the middle of that motherfucker. Ow! She said, don't nobody fucking move. Don't say shit. Don't fucking move. Shit. My boys was going, nigga, what's wrong with you? You got crabs? I said, I wish I did. Worth of change in my pocket at all times. People thought I was playing with the quarters, I was scratching my balls. My nieces and nephews in my brother's life. Uncle Marcus, you got some change? Hell no, my balls itch. Get the fuck away from me, motherfuckers. Shit. Anyways, I'm glad y'all came out. I'm glad y'all having a good time. But we're about to move on to the main event. Yes, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't even have to announce this band. Y'all know who he is. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. A big round of applause for your host for tonight.